I'd just like to say how excited I am that FHR can build out its continuum of care and the continuum of care for the Rhode Island community by opening the crisis stabilization unit.
I would explain the CSU as somewhat of a hospital diversion program. So it's for people who live within the community that need extra support but don't necessarily meet the criteria to be inpatient. So they can come here in order to get medication adjustments or to participate in groups and work with people one-on-one for therapy as well.
So it's the only one in the state of Rhode Island that will deal with folks having co-occurring disorders of behavioral health and developmental disabilities. And right now there's a significant need in the Rhode Island community for this type of service because the only option for these folks is to go to the hospital.
The CSU can provide clients a opportunity for care in a less restrictive environment, and it's a place where they can get the help they need. Also, I think it less stigmatizes the individual because they're not being in a hospital setting, they're not being restricted, but instead they're in the community, getting services, getting good quality treatment, and getting right back to their lives as soon as possible.
Our CSU is the first CSU in Rhode Island to have all individual rooms, which is helpful for people to have their own space. We also have a sensory room and a lot of space for clinicians and case managers and nurses to meet with people individually.
Right now, the other CSUs aren't always able to take folks who may need a little bit more care, whether it be developmental disabilities and or transgender. We have the luxury of offering single bedrooms and we have a very large sensory room. We have 2.5 full bathrooms, gender neutral. We have a very large common area where individuals can hang out, watch TV, a dining area. We have catered meals for everybody, large separate conference rooms where we can have either group therapy or individual therapy.
I'm excited about being the peer here, really being able to utilize my empathy, really being able to be open and honest with people and share with them the fact that recovery is possible and doing the work is not impossible. You know, it may seem overwhelming, but I will give people those tools to hopefully take away the feeling of overwhelm and replace that with the knowledge of success.
I just want to say how excited I am that it's opening. As a nurse, I very much love working with patients, and I really am so happy to know that we're going to be able to help folks stay out of the hospital, stay safe, and get the treatment that they need going forward so they can live a really high-functioning life.
I think the other thing I'd like to share is the importance of collaboration in our state, and we're able to find a way to launch something during these very difficult times, and I think that's a tribute to the folks that worked real hard to try to make this happen. And I just would add that it was folks' commitment and passion, I think, that really drove this process at the end of the day.